everyone, I'm Mike and this is the troubleshooting guide for my GTA 5 Intel / AMD switchable graphics hotfix. If you are getting something like this when you launch the hotfix, you are missing something that you need installed from a Microsoft website, and it's in a link in the description below. So far I've tested this hotfix with these versions over here, and also note that the launcher version doesn't matter, just the GTA 5.x version. So if you are going to report a bug, please use that version. Now if you are receiving some kind of error like this, or generally it's not working, you have to make sure that you run the hotfix administrator. And that means coming here and run as administrator. And mostly important, disables the Steam overlay or Overwolf overlay or whatever you are using, because that will for sure conflict with the loading process. If you open the game and the hotfix and you get an error message like this, or if something like this pops up in the hotfix, that means you open them at the same time. You have to open GTA 5 first, then wait sometimes 2, 3, 4 seconds, 2 is usually enough, and open the hotfix. However, if your game was already loading, if the hotfix shows some exceptions, like 2 or 3, and you get something like this message or this fatal exception, that means that you have to go to your config file and put a lower count. So if it's 6 or 5, try 4. This is an extreme rare case, but I'll just leave this here in case it's needed. Now, sometimes you may have a received invalid handle. Don't worry and just wait, the game will load. Wait, where is it? Over here, running as it should. So, for those who are having a different error code than this one over here, I mean exception code. For example, someone commented that the application was unable to start correctly and it's a different code. You have two options right now. Number one is to open the calculator, collect this value over here, copy it, as usual, programmer mode in calculator, go to hexadecimal, paste the value, and copy the value over here to the options file. So we will collect this value, put it here, paste it, and save it. The second method, and this may work for a lot of people, it shouldn't really matter the code, is coming here to the mode. And instead of zero, just write 1. It will completely ignore the exception code. If it is within the parameters of the problem that causes GTA 5 to crash, it should handle that exception. It's a matter of trying. Just change the mode from 0 to 1, and this should fix the problem for a lot of people. A lot of people ask if this works with Steam and cracked version. Yes, it does work with Steam and cracked version. I had the opportunity to test in both of them, and it did work pretty well. I'm forgetting something. Wait a minute. Yes, I'm totally forgetting something. Okay, I know what is it. So, if you are 100% sure that changing the mode to 1 doesn't work. You tried it and nothing else works. I added a debugger mode. What does it does is you launch your game, you wait a bit like usual, and you open the debug mode. The game will load and it will crash, but it will leave you with a file called debug the dot text. Wait a minute, I'll just make one. The game is loading and the hotfix is running, and now I'll just skip ahead to the end. Okay, now that the game finished running and it crashed, very well, can just close this and you will have a debug.txt file. As I said, if turning the mode to one doesn't work, just send me this file. And I will try to do what I can to help. So that's everything, guys, and see you next time.